forget your wallet, thousands of people are now paying by cell phone. A Des Moines-based company just launched the program tonight.
So how does it work? Emily Price shows us. Yeah.
First, you need a cell phone with internet access. Then you need an open mind.
At Mars Cafe, past the lattes and paninis, there's paper and plastic, cash and credit, how people have been paying for years.
As far as kind of out here in public, this is the first time.
Today, Ben Milne, CEO of Dwolla, has a new way to pay, and Nathan Wright is trying it out.
And this is the native application on my iPhone, so...
Wright went onto Dwolla's website and downloaded the application onto his phone. The app is now connected to his checking account, so he can move his money to Mars Cafe and beyond.
I can also send money to someone. So if I wanted to send money to Mike Templeton, I would choose him and select him, and then I'd be able to... put in my PIN number, and then the amount of money I want to send him.
In front of hundreds of friends and curious onlookers, Milne demonstrated how it works. He paid for a soy latte from his phone, and moments later, Mars had the money.
Oh, there we go.
Instead of paying a percentage per transaction, Mars pays 25 cents every time someone uses Dwolla. No more, no less.
The higher the prices get with your transaction amount, the more money you're saving, and you can transfer that savings to your customer, too.
It may be convenient and cost-effective, but is it safe?
I think there's always going to be a hurdle to build trust, but thankfully we're operating in a demographic where utilizing your cell phone and mobile banking and home banking is kind of commonplace.
Tonight, trust doesn't seem to be a factor. 1,000 people already feel safe and signed up.
Today we went national. That was a big day for us.
Right now, it's mostly web merchants using Dwolla. Mars Cafe near Drake is the first place where you can use it in person here in Des Moines.
And Dwolla isn't the first app to do this, right? There are others out there, right?
That's right. Google, AT&T, Verizon, T-Mobile, they all have apps already, but some of those require you to actually put a chip on your phone, and then they just swipe your phone when you go through the checkout.
And you were talking about security, as so were we, and the obvious question came up was, what happens if somebody steals your phone or something like that?
Well, each account is FDIC insured up to $250,000, similar to credit cards.
Okay. All right, Emily, thank you. Mm-hmm.